Hey everyone, welcome to American Idol Unaired. I'm your host, Bennett Cheer, and today we have a top 20 edition of the show because we've got Paige Ann, who you definitely remember from season 21. How's it going?
Good, how are you?
I'm great. It's so fun to see you again. We met briefly on live with Ashley Tankard from this season. That was really fun. I'm sure it's been cool to kind of reminisce and think back. It's been not that long, right, since you filmed the show. How have you been feeling?
I mean, it's been really crazy getting off of the American Idol high. I mean, it took a lot of days of just sleeping in and just like recuperating in Idaho Falls. Cause like, I mean, it's really boring here compared to, you know, the high life being on the show. So it's been fun though. I really like being home. I was really homesick while I was there. So
how do you like LA?
Too many people. Way too many people, but I like when I was doing American Idol there, but like, I don't think I'd ever say, hey, I want to move to LA, you know?
I literally thought to myself when I was visiting, because I went to see a few tapings of the show, I'm yeah. like, it must be such a either culture shock or just like, for those of you guys that live in different places, that some people grow up in LA, but for most of you guys, you're in such different parts of the country. So to go and do Idol is like such a different thing, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, I've been to California before I did Idol, but it was like when I was there for a long period of time, like Hollywood Week, and then I came for like for studio time. It's just a lot. I really just miss the quietness of my home, you know. It's a lot, but it's fun. I like it.
Well, what does that emotional process look like? Because you come back home and you probably miss it, but then do you miss the show and you're kind of balancing those two emotions?
Right now, it's just been balancing like missing friends. Cause okay. like it's the worst FOMO. I got and I was like, oh my gosh, Haven, don't snap me. Please don't snap me. Don't snap me right
yeah.
now. Like they were like showing me everything they were doing and I was like, I can't right now. This is too much. I just want to be there.
Yeah.
So it wasn't that I necessarily missed the stress of the competition. It was just I missed all my friends. So
does it go by quickly? Because it feels like a blur.
Honestly, I came home and it didn't even feel like any of it was real. Like it's definitely a fever dream. That's how it was for Hollywood Week and everything. Like it just doesn't feel real.
What about watching yourself back? Do you ever go and just look on YouTube or TikTok and just see the clips of yourself?
No. The first time I got cut, I did. Because like I was trying to see like what Idol spoilers had on me, even though they had nothing. They didn't figure out who I was until Hawaii. But I honestly, as of now, I do go back and watch the one that Idol didn't post, the one where I got eliminated. And I like listen through it, but I haven't done it in a while because I feel like it's just a way that I like critique myself overly much, even though there's nothing I can do to change it. And so I've been trying to get better about not doing it, but you know, I still catch myself doing it all the time.
Hey, top 20 is pretty cool. And I know it was also a big cut. Like that must have been a crazy night.
Well, I mean, when I had everyone else sitting there next to me, I didn't really feel that bad about myself because at that point, the competition isn't about talent. It's just everyone has to go home at one point. There's only going to be one person. So it was nice to at least have a big group of people going home with you so you all could do it together and not just, you know, be the only person going home. So it was nice having that group of support. Like we all went to dinner after and it was really fun. So
that last episode and first live show, incredible performances. It was like if you had to go out with a bang, right?
Watching that show, I mean, I feel like that was honestly one of the best shows that we as a group have put on. Like it was fire. Like I was sitting in the audience on my feet the entire time. It was so good.
Yes. And really like for the first live taping, you guys, I feel like didn't crack under the pressure. It was just totally so well produced, you know, Ryan kept it moving at a good pace.
Yeah. I mean, all the shows that we've done, like it didn't feel any different, like live shows and pre-tape shows. Like it doesn't feel any different to us because they've pushed us the same amount every time. And so, I mean, honestly, I think it's that they've prepared us for it really well. But I mean, it didn't feel any different. It just wasn't, oh, I have to wait 3 days to post this on socials. Like we just had to do it the day of. How hyped the audience is like, it's so fun to have such an interactive audience. I really liked Hawaii because that was like where the crowd was like really allowed to be, you know, interacting with you. And I liked that more than I liked studio because I felt like everyone was so far away. But I mean, it was still just nice having a crowd that wasn't all of the contestants like Hollywood Week. So
did you feel that Hawaii was a sense of like, I don't know, maybe not taking it for granted because you almost weren't there?
Honestly, I didn't take any moment for granted because I didn't think I'd even make it past auditions. like when I got my no from Katie in auditions and then I went on to Hollywood Week, I was like, oh, there's no way I'm making it past the first round. And so then when I just kept moving forward and then I got COVID, so then I was like, oh, now it's all out the window. So anytime I had the chance to sing, like I just kind of full sent it. So yeah, Hawaii definitely was my favorite performance that I did, because in that week I was like super in my head because I was like, oh, I'm the alternate and not good enough to be here. And like, it took me a minute to get into the group with everyone else because I kind of took the spot of someone else. And so that was their friend. And so it took me a second to like get in the group and like not feel like I'm the outsider at that point. And so, yeah, I just kind of full sent it and was like, I'll leave it out on the stage and hope it's enough. But yeah.
Let's go back in time. I want to find out when you were approached about the show, because Kyle cast you, right? Kyle Koo?
Yes, Kyle did cast me. I love him so much. So he actually reached out to me when I was 14, because I was hopefully going to be 15 before the show started. But I got through all the Zoom processes and I got to the point where I was going to be allowed to audition for the judges. But then they found out I was 3 days too young. And so I had to wait an entire year. And then I was able to kind of fast track through these Zoom auditions. And yeah, I got onto the season and it was really cool. I mean, those Zooms are absolutely terrifying. Yeah, they're really scary with like all the executive producers. And I'm like, it's just, you sit there and smile and you're like, please like me enough to put me through. I for sure love performing on stages more than I do through Zooms.
Well, let's talk about that for a minute, because I know people kind of like to sort of investigate how, you know, some people do Idol Across America, others are cast and, you know, they wonder, oh, well, is it like a fast pass to sort of be chosen? But it sounds like it's just as much work and just as challenging to sort of face, you know, literally face the music of what it means to go in front of producers and kind of, you know, pass the test of actually getting in front of the judges. You guys are all going on these meetings and being like, okay, so we're going to have you sing different songs and we're going to see what's your personality like and what's your story going to be. And really the job of the casting producer is to just kind of give you that platform as somebody else would who does Idol Across America. But sounds like it was really kind of stressful to sort of go through that process like everybody does on Zoom.
It for sure is probably about the same amount of stressful. I mean, including since you just have somebody reaching out to you and being like, hey, we really want you to do this.
So oh, then yeah.
So like you actually have to like live up to what they want you to be because it's their job. And so they want you to like do well. And so, I mean, yeah, I feel like it would be just the same amount of work, but I feel like everyone has a different journey when they're auditioning for the show. I've never talked to one person that has had like the same like journey on the show. And so it's really cool to see how everyone has like that unique twist. And so, yeah, I feel like it's a lot of hard work for everyone that does it, but I feel like everyone has a different path they take.
How did Kyle discover you? Was it a video, a TikTok that blew up?
My vocal coach was actually the person who sent me into him. I think my voice coach actually was his voice coach when he was on the show too.
Oh, Kyle was on the show?
He was, yeah. I can't remember.
I didn't know that. Yeah, that's cool. So you get in front of the judges, and at that point, what are you feeling about actually being on TV? I'm guessing you had never done anything like that before.
I mean, I've done like national anthems for televised things, but okay. I mean, actually having my story out there on TV and like people like knowing my personality, it was a little nerve-wracking because being vulnerable on TV isn't my favorite thing in the entire world. But I mean, I got used to it more and more, of course, as the show progressed. But I mean, I don't know. It was definitely surreal, but it became like the normal, which was really weird. I kept telling my mom, I'm like, isn't it weird that it's like normal for me to have to be on TV now? And I don't know. It's definitely a different feeling, but I feel like it didn't change anything like about me. I thought it would, like when I was younger and I was like, when I'm on TV, I'm going to feel so good and like feel famous. But I'm like, I feel no different. And it's crazy because you think you would after you get that much attention, but you know, I'm just like, I still want to do all the same things. Just chilling. I don't know.
I think they do a really good job on the show of just kind of presenting you guys as these people who you are. You know, it's like, they don't want you to change. They just want you to be yourselves. And it's like, you've had this dream for a long time, but you go on that stage and like, yeah, here you are. I'm Paige Ann from Idaho. This is me. This is my song. And people get to know you for who you've always been, you know?
No, one thing I really do like about Idol is that they make it so personable to each contestant. Like, it's not that they don't want you to do well. Like, they want every single person to do well. And they never set anyone up for failure. And one thing I found is the producers, like, they really don't want you to look bad. And I was like, every time whenever I was filming like B-roll and stuff, I'd always be like, oh my gosh, this is gonna look so bad, like they're gonna do me dirty, but they never did. And I was like, thank you, I appreciate that, guys, thanks. And so it's really cool to see how they actually like care about the contestants, and they don't just take it as a job, like they care.
I remember the first time we met you, I feel like we didn't kind of get to know you maybe as much because there was a video package. We talked about this on the live. It was all the contestants that had something to do with food. So because you had worked at a shaved ice place, there was like Karina with her meatball business. And then all of a sudden you come in and they didn't like fully explain it. So it was kind of just like you walked in with a shaved ice. So what?
That's maybe, what I was worried yeah. about, yeah. So basically when I was initially trying out for the show, the second time, so not when I was 14, but when I was 15. And so when I was trying out, I was working at a snow cone shack, and it's literally a shack on the river. And like, I was like, I think it's boring to call myself a snow cone maker. So I call myself a snow cone artist.
Ah.
And then Megan was like, oh, so like what kind of snow cones do you make? And I was like, well, actually I made the signature flavor, the Sour Patch Kid. And so I explained it to her, and I talked to her about snow cones for probably 15 minutes on my wow. last Zoom. And I mean, they just thought it was so funny that they were like, hey Paige, we're going to buy you a snow cone machine. You're going to make snow cones for the judges. And I was like, bet. So I didn't know how I was going to like walk into the room and like present that to the judges, but I didn't even script it. I was just like, okay, whatever I say will work, I guess. And I walked in and I was so nervous that I was like so smiley. Like I remember I went like Idaho Falls and I went my stepdad makes fun of me all the time for that, and I'm like, stop. But yeah, that's why I brought snow cones. They didn't really give much background on that, which I thought was funny because I said a lot about it in the interviews, but yeah.
Yeah, no, I was going to say, I feel like there wasn't a ton of like interview footage just from your audition in general. Like we got to see your name on the screen and hear you sing, but there wasn't as much of a story about you in the audition, yeah. I feel like.
Well, one thing I found is I feel like I built my story during the show because, you yes. know, with how many things happened to me, it's really unreal that I made it as far as I did. That's where my character really came through, was like, hey guys, I'm here to fight for my spot. You know,
as it progressed, you even mentioned earlier that you were always fighting for your place even before the stuff happened with Showstoppers into Hawaii. So it was a little maybe surprising to make it through Genre Challenge. And then we didn't get to see your duet. That was with Stefan Benz. Is that correct?
Stefan Benz. Yes. When they were telling us that we were supposed to like pick our own partners, I went first out of anyone in Hollywood Week.
Oh,
like,
okay. My
was the first person. And I bawled backstage the entire day. I cried that entire day because there's nothing I hate more than going first. So when they were like, hey, pick your own partners, I'm like, I didn't see anyone sitting. And I remember them putting clips on me of me going like, who do I choose? That embarrassed the crap out of me. I remember like Stefan kept always like following me. He was like following me the entire time while I was just like wandering because I didn't know who to pick. And then finally he was like, so Paige, what's the move? What's the move? And he kept like following me around. Like, Paige, what's the move? Because we became friends in like school. So it was so funny. And then finally Lionel came up to us and he was like, this is all that matters. So chemistry is all that matters. And because he thought me and Stefan were already partners. And then Stefan turns to me, he's like, so Paige, will you be my partner? And I was like, sure. And it was funny because he just followed me around. And I was like, you could have just asked me like, back there, okay. So we ended up picking You Are the Reason by Callum Scott, and yeah, it was pretty easy because we both pretty much knew the song already and knew like kind of what we wanted to do and like the cut we wanted to do. So we didn't stay up too late. We went in this bridal room because we weren't allowed to be like on camera because we're minors, so we had to go hide somewhere and like practice, and we couldn't sing in our hotel rooms. So we went and we found this bridal room and we sang in it, and we figured out our arrangement, and we were trying to figure out how to do chemistry like really well, like how to make it seem like we liked each other. And that we did. I mean, we played it up in interviews too. We were like flirting in interviews, just like, you know, teenage love. And so when we were doing our performance, we had a lot of stage presence, and in the ending, we ended up being like this close, and he like was supposed to hold my hand like this. On the last line, he pulled me in by my waist And I was completely caught off guard. And so Katie, when we were like finished, she was like freaking out. She's like, I just wanted you to kiss. And Luke was like, you want two minors to kiss? And they just kept going off and they were like, it was authentically 16. And they loved it. And when me and him walked out to do like interviews after, she was like screaming at Megan, the producer, like, are you sure they're not doing anything? You need to keep that. We played it off really well. And I mean, I love Stefan. He's so fun. But yeah, it was a solid duet.
That's awesome. Yeah. Going into Showstoppers, of course, before the results, how did you feel about the performance on stage?
Oh, I mean, I was absolutely terrified to do Showstoppers. But I tested positive. My mom tested positive for COVID the morning of duets. And so it was all crazy the morning. Like, me and him didn't get a rehearsal with like the vocal coaches like we were supposed to, because they had me quarantined until my new guardian would fly out. So my stepdad came to fly out to help me through. And so we didn't get any of that vocal coaching, but I tested positive not the next day, because that was the minors' day off, but the next day. And so I didn't even get to do any rehearsals with the band, nothing. I had to do all through Zoom. I remember trying to build our track with Chris Pooley, and he was like, oh, we'll just follow you at the beginning part. And I was like, no, you can't follow me, because I'm karaoke. It's like, and so it was really hard to like actually like coordinate how to like get the track how I wanted it, like through Zoom, and to be able to like perform it on Zoom. So, I mean, I was doing stuff like this to try and show that I had stage presence when all they could see was like my waist up. And so my actual performance, I mean, it wasn't my best because I was a little sick and like my voice wasn't really there, but I mean, I tried my best. So, I mean, there's nothing I can do to change it. So I'm actually pretty happy with how it went.
I'm sure that that's when things started to feel pretty emotional. Maybe that story started to build, because I mean, I think that's the first time we saw that happen. Someone performing, I mean, the judges are standing backstage, you're on that iPad and you're from your hotel room. So did you feel like in the moment you were able to sort of like maybe shut off the pressure that's like, oh my gosh, this is going to go so differently, and just focus on the performance? Or was it difficult to focus knowing, oh my gosh, like I feel almost limited by, you know, the lack of a big stage?
When I tested positive, I thought it was, if you get COVID, you're cut. So the fact that I had a chance to actually perform, I was just so beyond grateful, because it's like, when I was broke. Like, I thought everything that I just worked for went out the window. Like I worked so hard to like get to this point because I wanted to prove Katie wrong. And then I got COVID. And so when I just kind of had to full send it, because I didn't think I was going to make it through. Like, I knew walking into final judgment, I probably wasn't getting to the top 24. Like, there's no way, because I wasn't able to like throw myself on that stage like everyone else did. Like, it wasn't as good as I wanted it to be, because it's like, how do you show stage presence? Like, I just had to literally sing as loud as I possibly could so that they could hear a word that I said. Or like, I remember practicing for the Zoom, like the Zoom would like cut out because I'm a belter, and so I was too loud. And so that's why they only showed like four lines, because any other place in the song, like, it was all, the audio was probably crap. It was definitely a different experience, but I mean, I'm just thankful that I had the opportunity, because I thought it was, if I got COVID, I got cut. So
how smooth of a process was it just to get everything set up technically? Do you remember, was it like a simple experience, or was there a lot that went into just getting you on camera and able to film that whole thing?
So they gave me an iPad, but then we ended up not using the iPad. We ended up using my computer. And then I think I ran through my song with one of the producers like six times, and we joined different Zooms and we tried different devices. And the ending setup was like my suitcase on top of the table with towels stacked up, and then my computer. Wow. And then I had a speaker.
Did you ever watch American Idol when they had the COVID season where the entire live shows were all from home?
No, I didn't, but I've heard about it. They were like telling me about it. I probably should look up those performances. I feel like I'd relate to them.
Well, yeah, no, I mean, it's like, imagine every contestant in the top 20, plus the judges from home, plus Ryan from home. So I guess they're suited to help you in that moment. You know, it's almost like all that work led up to being able to be like, oh, we got this because, you know, we've done this for so many people.
They were talking about it a lot. And they also talked about Benson Boone, how he got COVID like right before Showstoppers and he still made it through. And so they were like, they were really being super nice about like trying to support me and like be like, this is all going to be okay. Like, you just keep moving forward. And I'm like, okay, I will.
Yeah. Well, right, because it's almost like the fact that you were in the hands of people that are so experienced probably made you feel comfortable. I know you talked about how nice it was working with the producers. They've done this. They know what they're doing. And I feel like that must have made it like less stressful in some ways.
Yeah. And it honestly just like grew my relationship with all of the producers because I gained that much more trust in them because I knew they didn't want to do me dirty. Like, they wanted me to do well. And so, yeah, I mean, I did feel that support from them. And it was a really nice experience. Like, I found that everything that's happened to me happened for a reason. But in the moment, it was rough. I don't think I've ever been that sad. Even my mom can attest to that. Like, I was just laying around. I didn't leave my room for 6 days.
As far as the final judgment, I feel like being chosen to be a part of a sing-off, as much as it may have been tough to not be picked for the initial top 24, you know, they do kind of say no to people without any sort of sing-off. So the fact that they had considered you and said, hey, we want you to sing with this person, I feel like that's still like, wow, like, this is a really tough decision, but we are still considering you. Like, we still like want you in this competition. And then to bring you back, it's like, you're still on their mind. You're still somebody that they want. And then ultimately you did come back.
Yeah. I mean, when I went into the sing-off, I didn't know who Megan was. I never met her before. And so I went and I hid in a bathroom and I stalked her. And when I watched all her videos, I was like, oh crap, there is no way I'm making it through this. But I was just happy to be out in my room and like have that opportunity to sing, like you said, because like some people just get a note with no explanation. But I had a chance to be like, no, I'm worthy to be here. Like, please put me through. And so when I went to that sing-off, it was actually like one of the funnest things I did on the show because I love last minute things. I love throwing things together at the last minute. I don't know why. It's just like, I love duets for that same reason. But yeah, I mean, doing it with Megan, she's a literal sweetheart. And it was just such a fun experience. Like, it didn't even feel like we were like going to compete against each other. It was like, we're going into this as a team, and whoever doesn't make it out, it's in God's hands, not ours. It was just such a cool experience. And I loved every second of it. And I mean, it was really cool to see that the judges actually wanted to give me that chance to like prove that I was worthy to be there. And so when I was asked to be the alternate after I went and did all my goodbye like interviews, I actually got pulled aside and they asked me to be the alternate, and I didn't really think much of it because there's no guarantee. And I was like, I'm not gonna get my hopes up. And they were like, good, so you're a good person for this spot because like we can't have you get your hopes up and be all sad. And I was like, okay. When I got that call of 4 days before I was supposed to leave for Hawaii, I mean, I literally bawled my eyes out on that Zoom. It didn't do me justice because they put me on another Zoom to like start talking logistics. And like one of the producers was like, okay, now that you're in the top 26, and I just bawled. It was like being led on by a guy because I was doing everything that all the top 26 was doing just without the commitment of actually being able to do that. So like be there. And so it was like, I kept telling the producers like, this is like being led on by a guy. They're saying all the things, but there's no commitment. And so it was a really fun experience, but yeah, I mean, it was just cool to be like considered for that second chance because there's so many other people that deserved it just as much as I did.
I mean, how fun was Hawaii aside from just performing?
Oh, it was literally a dream. I love Disney. And so being on the Disney resort, it was so fun. I mean, it was really windy while we were there, oddly, but yeah, it was just so much fun. Like I've never been, and my mom has always wanted to go and she had never been. So I was like, we're going to go to a Disney resort with American Idol. It was so much fun. I loved it.
And then people at home, I could see all the comments online. People were so excited that you were coming back.
Yeah. I mean, having that support, it just really felt unreal because honestly, like throughout my journey, I've always been my worst critic. And I feel like that's the same with everybody. And so it really was just a competition to like prove to myself that I feel like I'm worthy to be in this competition. And I'm still working on it. I'm still working on getting out of my head. Cause I struggled with it up to my last performance. And so, I mean, it was really cool. Like since I did that in February, I wasn't seeing all that support from people at home and like just everywhere on the internet. And so when it was actually airing, I was like, wow, I wish myself then could see what was going on now, because it really would have helped push me to like feel better about it and not feel so like I wasn't worthy. Like I, there was someone else that was more deserving of it. And so, yeah, I mean, it really boosted my confidence when everyone was like, no, please bring Paige back. Oh, we're so excited that Paige is back, you know? So it was nice.
Is that an agonizing wait when you're filming something and having to wait over 2 months to find out what the result is?
No. Honestly, I prefer it that way. I love like filming stuff with Idol, but the scariest part is the fact that it has to be on TV. So like when I was doing my mentoring with Noah, you know how they showed me like messing up over and over and over again with that account saying like, oh, I'm in my head. Well, like I was like, oh crap, that actually has to be on TV. And I know they're going to use it because I was just like really nervous to like, you know, be singing a Miley Cyrus song in front of Noah Cyrus. But like one thing I found is like, I don't like intimate things. So like with my audition, that's why I got so nervous, was because there was three people there deciding my fate. But once I got into Hollywood Week, I got more comfortable because there was crowds. So then when I went back to Noah and I was like, oh, there's like three people here. Oh, great. And so I just kept messing up over and over again. And I messed up 6 times in a row. They didn't even show every single time. I literally screamed and like jumped like 4 times. It was so funny. Yeah.
Well, how is that working with Noah?
Oh, she is the sweetest person you will ever meet. She's like the nice crystal girl. I don't know how else to explain it. Like, he's just so cool that I was like, I just want to be your best friend.
Gotten to work with quite a few behind the scenes people as well. Like all the vocal coaches that we don't get to see, Chris Pooley and the band. I mean, there's so many people that make this experience happen for you guys and bring the performances to life, right?
Yeah. I mean, the people behind the scenes really are doing the most work. Like it's so cool to see how this all is just like a working machine. A lot of these people work day and night nonstop. Like they love their job, but it's so much work. And so it's crazy to see how they get this all done and like how they control all these contestants. And like, I don't know, it was really cool to be able to meet everyone and network with everybody and make those personal relationships with everyone. And I mean, the vocal coaches and the band are just phenomenal at what they do. They're amazing at what they do. And so it's just really cool to see how all these musicians are just so quick to learn things and like adjust to like the little changes I want to make to my songs or just work with me. And it was just so cool. They made me feel so special in my few times that I got to work with them.
I know you got to spend a little bit of time at the studio. Like you go to LA and spend a couple weeks there. So I'm sure is that when you really get close with everybody? I know you're filming before, but
yeah, I mean, 26. I was really close with the minors because we had school all the time. And so I spent the most time with them in Hollywood Week, Hawaii. Hawaii was where we really got close. But I mean, like when we got to studio, we were already like besties. And so, I mean, everyone was just really close. And it's really like a family at that point. One thing I will never understand is how people are like, wow, that must be such a hard competition. I'm like, oh, it's a competition. Never like registered in my brain like, oh, I'm supposed to be competing against these people. But it really just feels like we all go into it as a team and like just kind of hope for the best for each other.
Any fun memories from Idol school? Because I feel like there must be fun stories and it must be a lot of fun to break from the normal school setting and be out there with all your friends.
I mean, me and Haven got on the same nap schedule, so there's like videos out there of me, Haven, and Tyson all just knocked out on the floor, on couches. Like we just slept anywhere we possibly could. I mean, school wasn't like we had to do school, but I mean, our school teacher was the sweetest person ever. And I love her. And she brought her dog Romeo. I don't know if you've seen him on Haven's Instagram. She's yes. Posted. It's just like a place where it's like therapy. It's where we just, I don't know, we can serve our energy so that we can just put it all out there in interviews, performances and all that. But fond memories, there's so many. There's a lot of inside jokes that would probably be long stories to tell and not very productive.
That's amazing. I feel like you must have made all these lifelong friends that you'll just keep in touch with and continue supporting for years to come.
And I'm so excited to see like all these people develop as artists. There is no way that not every single one of us is not going to have a career in music. Like it's crazy to see like all the different artistry coming from each and every one of them, but every single one of them can have such a prosperous career. They're all so amazing. And so I'm just really excited to be like front row at their concert and be like, hey guys, I was on American Idol with them. Hopefully I'll be able to have my own musical career. But if not, I'm excited to go.
No, of course. Are you kidding me? That's like you take turns going backstage at each other's shows and just reminiscing about the good old days. Right. And then cheering each other on. Right.
Yeah, I'm so excited. It's going to be so fun because I know that like our support and love for each other does not stop when we get eliminated. And so I'm really excited.
Let's just talk briefly about Post Idol, like anything that's been going on or what's next for you. What's going on?
I'm hopefully going to be releasing music as soon as my contract ends. I've been writing and going around. I'm going to be going to Nashville here in a little while to go to Songhouse and write. Hopefully Haven, I get to go visit Haven and write with her. So that'll be really fun. I'm hopefully just going to keep pushing forward because the work doesn't stop. And I really want this to be my career. And so I'm really hoping that my work will, you know, prove to be worth it. And so, yeah, I've just been picking up a lot of gigs. I'm seeing it Supercross next weekend. So that's going to be cool. I've been doing that for a long time. So nothing new, but I'm just doing all the things, picking up as many gigs as I possibly can, going to be writing music and releasing it here soon. But yeah.
By the way, I know you said one thing earlier about how it was kind of interesting filming the show, but people at home hadn't seen it. What has it been like going back now that everybody has watched?
For my date at prom, we were in Utah. And literally, I got stopped for pictures probably every 10 minutes.
Oh my gosh.
Like,
is it stressful?
I don't understand. Like, it doesn't click in my head why people think I'm so cool. So, like, when I'm, I don't understand it even to this day because they're like, oh my gosh, Paige. And I'm like, why are you screaming at me? Like, I have not changed. Like, I promise. Or, like, people ask me, like, follow them back constantly. And I'm like, I promise me following you is not going to give you clout. Like, I don't know. And so it's just, like, not clicking in my head that, like, apparently American Idol makes me, like, cool in Idaho. And so I guess that hype is going to leave soon, but I just like the support I've been receiving has just been so cool. And I mean, I love the support, but I'm getting used to it slowly. I'm getting used to it. All the attention and like people are recognizing me and I love it, but I also hate it all at the same time. Cause that means I have to be put together every time I go out in public. And like, I went to Walmart last night, my sweats, no makeup on, hair up. Like I did my live. Like just looking like I'm ready for bed. And I went in public and people were recognizing me and I was like, don't look at me. Stop. No.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, I mean, the support I've just been receiving locally. And I mean, the fact that I've been able to be recognized, like me, Haven and Tyson went to Disneyland and like, there was so many people that recognized me. And then they were like, Paige, why are you here? Cause it was before, like I was announced being in the top 26 and I was like, I mean, it's just been really cool to have that support and like finally be able to be like, yeah, people recognize me in public and want to take pictures with me. It's been really cool.
Well, maybe it's not that American Idol makes you cool. Maybe you're just already cool.
Yeah, maybe it's just because I'm cool. But American Idol made me cool.
It's just the extra thing.
They showed everyone how cool I am. You know?
Yes.
How weird I am, that I cry a lot, you know, all the things.
All the cool things.
All the things.
Paige, where do we need to follow you to stay tuned for music and Songhouse and everything like that that's coming up for you? It's all super exciting.
My socials are the Paige Ann. I think Instagram is the Paige Ann official, but yeah, just all social media. I try and post as much as I possibly can to keep everyone updated, but yeah.
One final question. It's been really fun. We've been closing all our episodes with this lately. One piece of advice for anybody thinking of auditioning for American Idol.
Don't ever give up. Even if you get a no, just keep pushing forward because the only person you're competing against is yourself. And so if you keep improving yourself each day, what's the worst that could happen? You get cut twice.
And if you don't get on the show the first season, they might call you back the next year.
No, literally, they're always looking for people the next season. And that's one thing I found is they don't air a lot of people that were there so that they can come back.
Here on American Idol on Air. And I mean, if you want to follow us, Idol on Air podcast, Instagram, and TikTok, we have tons of interviews with contestants that you didn't see. We've got many coming up as well as aired exceptions like this one. Our top 20 edition with Paige. So I really appreciate your time. And guys, make sure you're subscribing if you aren't already, wherever you are watching or listening. Really appreciate it. Thanks so much. And Paige, thank you for being a part of American Idol on Air.
Thanks for giving me the opportunity.